Progress OpenEdge Replication with replication sets enables high availability in two situations: in the case of the unexpected loss of a source database, and in the case of planned downtime. With replication sets, you have two target databases, a primary target and a secondary target, that you replicate to. Even when the source is offline, replication can continue between the targets. In this video, we will look at planned downtime. In planned downtime, before you bring the source database down for maintenance, you switch the roles of the source and the primary target. The primary target is now the temporary source. When you shut down the original source for maintenance, replication will continue between the temporary source and the secondary target. After maintenance is done, you reintroduce the original source into the replication set. When the databases are synchronized, you return the replication set to its original configuration. Let's see how this works. We have already implemented a replication set. It consists of three databases: the source database, DB0, the primary target, DB1, and the secondary target, DB2, all of which are running. We take a quick look at the database log to make sure that the databases are synchronized. Suppose we want to shut down DB0 for maintenance. Before we do that, we switch the roles of the source and the primary target databases. We check the database logs and see that DB0 is now a target and that DB1 is now a source. Next, we shut down DB0. At this point, the replication set has two databases, DB1 and DB2, and the replication will continue to take place between them. Once the necessary maintenance work is done on DB0, we reintroduce it as a target to the replication set. To do that, we first restart DB0 as a target. Then we terminate the replication server running on DB1. Then we restart the replication server. This will add DB0 as a target to the replication set. We check the database log to confirm that. We see that DB0 is now synchronized with DB1. We are now ready to return the replication set to its original configuration. We first update the transition to agents property in the replication properties file of DB0, DB1, and DB2. Then, we switch the database roles of DB0 and DB1 so that DB0 becomes the source and DB1 the primary target. Finally, we check the database logs to confirm that the replication set has indeed returned to the original configuration. You have now seen how OpenEdge replication works in the case of planned downtime. To learn more about implementing OpenEdge replication, take the Implementing Progress OpenEdge Replication for High Availability course.